Sierra Leone is a very beautiful country, as you can see, but this Sierra Leone has just recovered from a very vicious civil war, and the mystery of this civil war is still baffling to the international community. How a nation that is so beautiful and so peaceful could have gone through such a terrible, terrible situation.
My name is Anthony B. Conte. This is Sierra Leone, my country. Sierra Leone is located in West Africa and flanked in the west by the Atlantic Ocean. In 1462, the Portuguese arrived and called it Sierra de Leone because the mountains looked like resting lions. Freetown is the capital city with a population over 1 million. Freetown was founded as a home for freed slaves from North America, Jamaica, and London. In 1961, we received independence from the British. Freetown was known as the Athens of Africa because of its excellent education system. The nation relies on mineral mining, especially diamonds.
...90% of the people in this country have never seen a diamond. And there they were, having their arms and limbs chopped off for nothing that was of their own making.
This was the most dangerous place to be on earth at the time.
The thing where they're passing only the bondios, all. You understand? Cotton, cotton bobby, cotton tongue. Then one day, I'm not fit, and I'm afraid of Sierra Leone right now.
Then they got me the lunch attack. They gave up enter my room, they killed me mama, and they gave hold me. Me and Valerie. They gave up another 8 years, they all ran to Dubai. They would have wounded me, I had to put up on me. They give me yoke somehow. They get up from here back. They said, no, sorry, nobody. They said, this time, no, sorry, nobody. They begin first, you know, they begin giving gun, they begin cutting her now. We begin to kill now.
The rebels began chopping hands off. The election slogan was, "The future is in your hands." So the rebels chopped the hands off anyone they could find to stop them from voting.
My name is Almani.
Almani, what happened to you?
Rebel
cut your leg. What?
On the wall.
On the wall,
Sierra Leone is now officially the poorest nation on earth. The life expectancy for males is 37 years old and 43 years old for females, the lowest in the world. We are now rebuilding the country. Our new government is focusing on development and reforms. We need foreign assistance. We need NGOs actively involved. Churches need to be involved in health services, poverty eradication, and education.
Okay, now we've got this leg here. See if you can put it on, and maybe you can walk properly now, okay? So put it on.
Okay. I don't care how.
It's long. It was long.
I don't come up for G60. I could run on for that.
You know, this, give me this. Stop working, see if you can work, okay? You can work. You can work.
Okay,
you can work. Are you happy?
Give me this.
It's a miracle. Not walking alone. A miracle. It's a miracle.
Understand something.
He said, while we understand something,
I know you are suffering.
He said, in God's name, we just suffer.
Some of you cannot walk very well.
Some of you don't walk fine.
Some of you don't have a hand.
Some of you don't get hand.
But I want to tell you something.
He said, why you want to tell me something?
You can see.
We go see.
I cannot see.
And he don't see.
But you see, all of us have a pain.
He said, we all get pain.
Already, let me tell you what we are doing. We're applying to the Ministry of Lands for land for you, that we can build you houses there. With the protection of the Holy Body, the angels in heaven, and Saint John the Forerunner, and of the saints we commemorate today, and all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us as a good and loving God. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Bless the living God.
Hallelujah.
Mr. Chavez, we gave you some sewing machines. Can you tell us how it's been used?
Yes, the sewing machines we have sent to the female section. Some female inmates are now actively engaged in acquiring skills in tailoring.
You know what I promised you? Every woman that leaves this jail and this school will get a machine. We will give you a machine.
Yes. But being that now we have come to learn this area, we hope that when we leave this place and go out with our machines, we engage ourselves in doing this sewing so that we will never come here again. So we thank you very much.
How many children would be around here, my friend?
No, obviously we are talking about up to 3,000 to 4,000 children.
Would you say a lot of children are not going to school here?
Yeah. We can say we still need to cater up to 95% of these children to go to school.
Yes. Tell me about your school.
My school is big.
It's big. Yes, it's very big. How many students are here?
500.
Building, we need a big building. We don't have enough building.
You have books?
I have books, but not enough.
In July of 2008, we acquired this school, which is a primary and high school in Syke Street, Freetown.
We're inside one of the classrooms of this school at Syke Street, and you can see this is the furniture that we're using. This is the other situation of this school at Syke Street. We even found boys playing football inside the classroom. They were playing football. Imagine the situation here. There's no discipline, there's no control. They can do anything they want. Half the people here don't even belong to this school. They're just outsiders coming in. These people are just invaders. They don't belong to the school. They just jump in, use the school, and do whatever they want. What we've done for this school is create walls all around. We're creating walls because there is a security problem here. People are invading this school from the outside. We're going to be creating various projects like a clinic, tailoring school, computer school, and various other projects.
This is the site where the Orthodox Cathedral will be built. This is the site where our teachers' college will be built, and it is expected to be completed by September 2009. This is our engineer, Mr. Pella. He's responsible now here for this building.
Since it is development and it is forever, so that's the reason why we are doing our best to do it the best way and according to the international standards.
I also have to point out that all the workers are here are all local people. So all the money that we are bringing in, it's going to stay here.
Work, all the work, sinking sand. So let it be solid work. And bless all those.
Thank you.